fell in love, glad as I can be. Met a girl, fell in love, bad as I can be. But I think all the time, is she true to me? Cause there's nothing in this world to stop me worrying about that girl. I found out I was wrong, she was just too tiny. I found out I was wrong, she just kept on lying. Now she tries to tell the truth, but I just can't believe.
What happened to your finger?
Shh. It's okay, I'll tell you. I'm adopted, did you know that? Well, I am. When I was 14, I went to find my real family. They live in Indiana.
All right, now just set one of them hickory trunks right up top there, Sister Maggie.
Did you try to sew it back on?
Wasn't worth it. I want to ask another question.
You've already asked another question.
One more.
Go ahead.
If you weren't afraid, what would you want to do to me?
I'd pull your eyes out of your head.
That's sweet.
I'd put them in my own skull. I'd look around so I could see this street the way I used to when I was your age.
Well, is it your belief then that folk music has perchance failed to achieve its goals with the Negro cause or the cause of peace?
You know, saying cause of peace, it's just like saying, it was like a hunk of butter. You know, I don't know how you can listen to anybody who wants you to believe is dedicated to the hunk and not the butter.
I'm not sure I follow.
You know, I didn't come out of some cereal box. There's no one out there who's ever going to be converted by a song. There's no Phil Oak song that's going to keep a movement moving, you know, or a picket line picketing. His songs act as a personal conscience. Like burning a draft card or burning yourself. Doesn't do a damn thing. Except to disassociate you and your audience from all the evils of the world. I refuse to be disassociated from that.
My name's Clementine, by the way.
I'm Joel.
Hi, Joel. No jokes about my name. Oh, no, you wouldn't do that. You're trying to be nice.
It means merciful, right? Clemency.
Although it hardly fits. I'm a vindictive little bitch, truth be told.
Gee, I wouldn't think that about you.
Why wouldn't you think that about me?
I don't know, it seemed nice, so.
Oh, now I'm nice? God, don't you know any other adjectives? I don't need nice. I don't need myself to be it, and I don't need anybody else to be it at me.
Okay. Buckle up, buddy. Sorry I'm late.
I'm used to it.
Listen, pal, I don't think we're gonna have time to catch a movie today.
Is it because you're getting reviewed?
Yeah, how'd you know about that?
Mom told me.
What'd she say?
She said you might be a little worried.
She said I was worried?
Yeah.
Well, Mom doesn't know me that well, okay?
She's pretty spot on about you.
Oh yeah, you know what mommy thinks I should be doing?
What?
She thinks I should get a food truck.
I like food trucks.
Yeah, I like food trucks. Who doesn't like food trucks? You can picture me driving around a food truck? I'm a chef. I work at a restaurant.
Okay.
Can you recall no melody of mine? I was the most famous composer in Europe. Yeah. What about this one?
Yes, I know that. Oh, that's charming. I'm sorry, I didn't know you wrote that.
I didn't. That was Mozart.
An immaculate heart is already a luxury.
Immaculate fart? You wanted that, not me.
Miguel saw someone knifed in front of him at Sac High. Is that what you want? So you're telling me that you want to see somebody knifed
he
right in front of you?
He barely
right
saw that. I want to go where culture is,
but
like New York.
How in the world did I raise such a
snob? Or at least
snob.
Connecticut or New Hampshire,
well,
where writers live in the
get
woods.
Get into those schools anyway.
Mom!
You can't even pass your driver's test.
Because you wouldn't let me practice
the way
enough.
That you work, or the way that you don't work, you're not even worth state tuition, Christine.
My name is Ladybird.
Well, actually, it's not, and it's ridiculous.
Call me Ladybird like
Christine.
You said you would.
You should just go to City College. You know, with your work ethic, just go to City College and then to jail, and then back to City College, and then maybe you'd learn to pull yourself up and not expect everybody to do everything.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
This one would get me arrested, and this other one's impossible because we need Eddie Vedder and the time machine. I think we've done everything on the list that we could actually do, so.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, I think that's it.
What about this?
Oh my God, that would be awesome. It's impossible.
No, it isn't. We have $1,000 in our bank account, and we're young and irresponsible.
I mean, our car would break down. There's no way we could even get there.
So, I'll steal my dad's car. Look, this is a stupid idea, but right at this exact second, we have enough momentum to do something stupid before we realize how stupid it is.
You are absolutely right. No thinking, just stupid.
Yes!
I tell you what, you play whatever you want. I'm just gonna take a real quick snooze for like 12 hours, so I'm fresh.
The new day dawns, and I am practicing my purpose once again. It is fresh and it is fruitful if I win, but if I lose, all will be well. You can ask me how, but only time will tell.
So much more beautiful than I could have ever even imagined.
Yeah. I'm trying to find a way to be annoyed by it, but coming up empty.
Thank you so much. I never would have ever done this without you. Thank you. Where's all the faces? The presidents.
I won't settle for anything less than the brutal truth. Brutal. Brutal. Each day I'll hand you a scrap of paper. It'll tell you what happened to you that day. You felt a lump in your breast. You looked at your wife and saw a stranger, etc.
Peyton.
What?
When are we going to get an audience in here? It's been 17 years.
All right. I'm not excusing myself from this either. I will have someone play me to delve into the murky, cowardly depths of my lonely, fucked up being. And he'll get notes too, and those notes will correspond to the notes I truly receive every day from my God.
I do know what you're feeling, Susie Bean. I've had moments myself where I say, what am I doing here? Who made this decision? How could I allow myself to do something so stupid? And why is it still happening? We women are more emotional.
I hate you.
Don't say hate.
Why not? I mean it.
You think you mean it in this moment. You're trying to hurt me.
Exactly.
Poor Susie. Why is everything so hard for you?
They're in love. You just want to be together. What's wrong with that?
Oh my God. How are we gonna get these fish hooks out?
Wanda.
Hmm.
No one dislikes you, Wanda.
Thanks.
Oh, you're welcome. No, it's an involuntary response in their amygdala. They can't help but be afraid of you.
Are you?
My amygdala is synthetic, so.
I used to think of myself one way, but after this, I am something else. I'm still me, I think, but that's not what everyone else sees.
You know who's coming tonight? We're being reviewed by the most important critic in the city.
Yes.
You know that his online blog was sold to AOL
for $10 million.
That's right.
Yes.
You knew that.
Yes, I know.
Okay.
He's a big deal, and that's why I want to cook him a good menu.
You want to give him? You want to cook him a good?
Yeah, I want to cook him some good food.
Yeah. Well, then.
And our place is in a fucking creative rut.
In a rut.
In a creative rut.
You do know that we're doing better than any place in the neighborhood.
I'm not talking about how much money we're making. I'm talking about creatively the food that we're serving. It's the same food we've been serving for 5 years.
You remember what happened when you put guts on the menu? Huh?
Are you talking about my sweetbreads? Is that what you mean by guts?
Yeah. When you put that artsy shit on the menu, people don't like it. Not one person ordered your sweetbreads. If you bought Stones tickets and Jagger didn't play Satisfaction, how would you feel? Would you be happy?
No.
No. You'd burn the place to the fucking ground. Carl, do what you want tonight. Okay, you're the chef. You know what I think? I think you should play your hits.
There's a possibility. There's a possibility.
Disappeared. Like everything else. Who else can I talk to? I'm lost.
There's a possibility.
When you left.
There's a possibility.
And he left. You took everything with you. Absence of him is everywhere I look.
I'm sorry, Walt.
It's not your fault. Which injuries are you apologizing for, specifically?
Specifically? Whichever one still hurt.
Half of those were self-inflicted. I hope the roof flies off and I get sucked up into space. You'll be better off without me.
Stop feeling sorry for yourself.
Why?
We're all they've got, Walt.
It's not enough.
When are you gonna take it?
Sometimes I don't. If I like a moment, I mean me, personally, I don't like to have the distraction of the camera. I just wanna stay in it.
Stay in it.
right here. Oh, it's gone. It's gone.
Wait.
What?
I don't know.
What
just
do
wait.
You want, Joel?
Just wait. I don't know. I want you to wait for just a while.
Okay.
Really?
I'm not a concept, Joel. I'm just a fucked up girl who's looking for my own peace of mind. I'm not perfect.
I can't see anything that I don't like about you.
But you
right
will.
Right now, I can't.
But you will. You know, you will think of things, and I'll get bored with you and feel trapped, because that's what happens with me.
Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Did you?
No. Come here.
Go home, man. Go home. You've been here all night. Go home. Get some sleep.
Come here.
What is that?
That's carne asada. Check it out.
Oh. Wow.
Good?
It's fucking unbelievable, man.
Is it?
Holy shit.
No, seriously.
No, I'm serious.
Tell me the truth.
I'm telling you the truth. It's incredible.
It's a good seasoning?
Between you and me, in 100 words, where do you think Van Gogh rates in the history of art?
Well, big question, but to me, Van Gogh is the finest painter of them all. Certainly the most popular great painter of all time, the most beloved, his command of color the most magnificent. He transformed the pain of his tormented life into ecstatic beauty. Pain is easy to portray, but to use your passion and pain to portray the ecstasy and joy and magnificence of our world, no one had ever done it before. Perhaps no one ever will again. To my mind, that strange, wild man who roamed the fields of Provence was not only the world's greatest artist, but also one of the greatest men who ever lived.
Vincent, sorry.
I'm sorry, is it too much?
No, they are tears of joy. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
Sorry about the beard.
Joy, you gotta fix this. Get up there. Sadness, it's up to you.
Me?
Sadness?
Sadness?
I can't, Joy.
Yes, you can. Riley needs you. All right, thank you. We will. Her teacher hasn't even seen Riley all day.
What?
What was she wearing last?
I
do you even remember what... Riley!
There you are, thank goodness.
We were worried sick. Where have you been? It's so late. Don't be mad.
are not mad. You know what? I miss Minnesota too. I miss the woods where we took hikes.
And the backyard where you used to play.
Spring Lake, where you learned to skate. Come here.